Hey guys, today I'm going to talk about how to switch between general form and turning point form for a quadratic equation. So why would you want to switch between two ways of expressing the same equation? Well, let's have a look at this equation here, y equals x squared plus 6x plus 14. If we try to graph that equation, let me just get rid of my previous graph. So if we try to graph y equals x squared plus 6x plus 14, we get this graph here. And let me just zoom out a little bit. So we can see that the turning point is located at x equals negative 3 and y equals 5. However, this equation doesn't tell us anything about the turning point. It's not until we draw the graph we can see where the turning point of this graph is located. Now, however, if you have a look at this other equation, y equals x plus 3 in brackets squared plus 5. If I try to draw that graph, so I'm going to delete this graph. Y equals bracket x plus 3 bracket squared plus 5, you get the exact same graph. Now, however, in this equation, we can see already that the turning point is x equals negative 3 and y equals 5, and that tells us as part of the formula. So when a quadratic equation is in turning point form, we can already see that the turning point exists. So when y equals x minus b squared, sorry, let me just change that. So when x equals x plus a squared plus b, we know that the turning point will be at x equals negative a and y equals b. Right, we can see that in our graph. So this is the turning point form. A is 3, so the turning point here exists at x equals negative a, which is negative 3, and the turning point exists at y is equal to 5, so b is equal to 5, which means y is equal to 5 for our turning point for the graph. So the question now is, how do I switch from this form into this form? Because once I rewrite the equation into this new turning point form, I can see where the turning point is without even drawing the graph. So the process to switch from our general form to our turning point form is called complete the square. It's called complete the square because we have a bracket squared, and so therefore this process is called complete the square. And I'm going to teach you how to do that using this example. So let's firstly have a look at our perfect square formula, which says that a plus b squared is equal to, if you expand it out, it'll give you a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. Right, if you're not sure how to expand brackets, have a look at the previous expanding tutorial. So as you can see here, we want to somehow manipulate our equation so that we can put these three terms back into something squared plus a constant term. So let's just have a look at the first two parts here of this equation. So this first two terms of our equation matches our first two terms in our perfect square formula, where we have x squared plus 6x. Right? We just don't know what we should put in here. And as you can see in our formula, a is x, so we know that it'll be x plus, we don't know what b is, squared. So what are we going to put here for b squared, and what are we going to put in this box for b? Now, if we know that 2ab is equal to 6x, which we can see matching here, 2ab is 6x, and we know that a is equal to x, so we can deduce what b is equal to. So 2 times x times b is 6x. I know the b and the 6 look a little bit similar, so we can rearrange this equation to make b on its own. So b is equal to 6x divided by 2x, which is equal to 3. Because 6 divided by 2 is 3 over 1. So b is equal to 3. So we can simply now put in this box, 3, x plus 3 squared is x squared plus 6x plus 3 squared, which is x squared plus 6x plus 9. Now notice how in the equation that we're trying to convert, it has x squared plus 6x plus 14. So basically what we're going to have to do now is, so we had the equation x squared plus 6x plus 14, and we want to complete the square. On this equation. So what we're going to do is make it equal to 0, and we're going to move the 14 to the other side. So I have x squared plus 6x equals negative 14. And now, because we know that we can put these back into brackets if we had x squared plus 6x plus 9. So what I'm going to do now is plus 9 on both sides. So I'm going to write plus 9 on both sides. Notice how this equation has not changed at all, right? Because you can do whatever you want as long as you do the same thing to both sides. So therefore, we on the left-hand side, we now have x plus 3 squared equals negative 14 plus 9, which is negative 5. And now we can simply move the minus 5 to the other side, which makes it x plus 3 squared plus 5 is equal to 0. So we have just completed the square of our equation x squared plus 6x plus 14 is equal to x plus 3 squared plus 5. Which is the what we wanted to do in the beginning, changing from this form into this form, changing from the general form to the turning point form. So now we know, without even drawing the graph, that this equation y equals x squared plus 6x plus 14 will have a turning point at x is equal to negative 3 and y is equal to 5. Okay, that concludes our tutorial on how to change from general form and turning point form. Thanks for watching. See you next time.